students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject, distributed system is a clock synchronization. So in the previous video, I explained about what exactly the synchronization and what is the synchronization role that is playing in centralized system as well as in the distributed system. So if you're having any doubt, just go through that video and be clarity about what is a synchronization role in centralized system and if it is a distributed system. Okay, so after that, come to this topic, that is a clock synchronization. So how can I manage the clock and I have to synchronize the system? I said this is one system, another system, another system. So suppose let's take three systems. It is present in one country, another country. So different countries, UK, US, and let us take India. So all the systems that are present in different countries, and they are going to be communicate with each other. So it is a distributed environment. So in this distributed environment, I want to maintain the data that should be sending or receiving in synchronized manner. I have to maintain it synchronized. So for that, you need to maintain the clock. The clock has to be synchronized. So that is a concept that I want to explain in this video, the clock synchronization. So first of all, what is a clock synchronization that you have to know? After that, what are the categories that are taking place to synchronize the clock in the distributed environment? Okay, so what is a clock synchronization? A clock synchronization is a mechanism. You call it as a mechanism. A clock synchronization is a mechanism to synchronize the time of, all computers in distributed environment or in distributed system. So whatever I said. So it is a mechanism to synchronize the time. I have to maintain the same time. Okay, even though they are showing different times in their respected countries, I have to maintain the same time for all the computers so that I can maintain the synchronization in the distributed environment. So is it possible to maintain? Yes, otherwise you can't maintain the data synchronously. Okay, you can't send the data synchronously in the distributed environment. Okay, so synchronization in distributed system is more complicated than in centralized system. So I already said, so distributed synchronization in distributed is harder to implement when compared to the centralized system. Why? Because the former have to use the distributed algorithm. So we have to use the distributed algorithms to maintain data synchronization in distributed system. So the distributed algorithm have some properties. Distributed algorithms have some properties. So what are the properties? So with the help of these properties, we are using the distributed algorithms to maintain the clock synchronization in the distributed environment. So the first property is the relevant information is scattered among multiple machines. Information is scattered among multiple machines. Okay, among multiple machines. And then the processes make decisions based only on local information, and one more point is a single point of failure. Suppose any failure is there, a single point of failure, in the system should be avoided. So these are all the different properties for the distributed algorithms to maintain the data synchronously. And one more thing is no common clock are required. No common clock or other precious global time sources exist. Precise global time source exist. Okay, so these are all the different properties of the distributed algorithm. So I said in centralized system, time is unambiguous. So when a process wants to know the time, it has to make a system calls. Whereas in the distributed systems, time is ambiguous. So remember that in the centralized, time is unambiguous. Why I'm saying this is unambiguous? Because when a process wants to know the time, it has to make a system call. Whereas in the distributed environment, in the distributed system, the time is ambiguous. Time is ambiguous. So you can say that this is the difference also. So here the where each machine has its own clock. In the distributed environment, each machine has its own clock. Okay, the time along each machine may also vary. So it is possible to synchronize all the clocks in distributed system. So it is possible to synchronize all the clocks in distributed system. So because each system is having their own clock, whenever each system is having their own clock, if it is within the country, there is no need of bothering about that, because it is centralized. Here the time is unambiguous. All systems are maintaining the same clock. But in the distributed environment, one system is present, different systems are present in different countries. So we have to make all the systems in the distributed system has to maintain the time ambiguous. So it is possible to synchronize all the clocks in distributed system. Okay, so I hope you understand what is the main problem that we are occurring and how these distributed the clock synchronization is going to be synchronized to make the clocks maintain the same time in the distributed environment, so that we can send the data and receive the data without any loss and within a time. Thank you.